十分钟。
Brothers and sisters, we have one more session of sharing, and this one will be for 30 minutes.
求主耶稣带领我们。
Let's ask God to guide us.
我们一起默祷。
Let's pray in silence.
哈利路亚，阿门。
阿门。
我们要把这一次在这个爱的这个主题里面呢，我们来最后分享几件事情。
So we want to make share a few more things about the topic of love.
回到家以后练习一定会失败，会觉得很失望。
And if you try to practice, you might lose hope when you go home.
特别是哦，你忍不住就说话了，对不对
？Especially if you can't hold it anymore, you say something.
没有关系，在你的孩子的面前，假如你真的说了，真的骂了。
No matter if in front of your children you have said it,
或是跟你的配偶真的说了，也真的骂了。
Or perhaps in front of your spouse you have scolded them.
记得哦，要做一点叫做什么？补充，做一点修补的工作。
Remember that you have to do some repair work.
那就是说，你的孩子就看到你们两个在吵架，对不对
？That's to say, if your children see you two fighting.
昨天是说趁他睡觉的时候吵。
Yesterday we talked about how you should fight while they're sleeping.
今天要讲说你真的没办法，他就看到了。
But today we talked about it. You cannot help yourself, and they saw it.
那现在你已经上过课。
So now that you have taken this course,
也知道不可能，有时候不可能，他不可能。没看见，他会看见。
And you learn that sometimes it's not possible for them to not see it.
不用觉得怎么样。
So don't feel anything.
你马上跟你的配偶演出下一场。
Immediately, you and your spouse should act the next act.
就跟他说，哎呀，这是在他前面哦，孩子在前面。
And make sure that the children are front.
就是说，哎呀。刚刚真的很抱歉啊
！And say, oh, just now, I'm really sorry.
然后另外一个就是说，哎呀，没事啊，原谅你吧。
And the other one will say, oh, that's not a problem. I'll forgive you.
就是连这个你都要先练习演出。
And so now you have to rehearse this act.
所以你还没有孩子的时候，先演几次。
So before you have children, try to act a few times.
演习惯了以后有孩子就比较能上演。
And once you rehearse it a few times, then when you have children, it'll be easier.
所以要记得哦，你吵归吵，但是你要和好。
So remember that if you do argue, you have to come back together.
那这个是说刚好你的孩子看见。
And so this is talking about if your children just happen to see it.
你的孩子要看见你怎么和好。
Your children have to see how you reconcile.
他那个大脑里面的那个紧张的那个程度就会降低。
And so the severity of his brain being in the fight will reduce.
好吗？练习哦。
So you have to practice this.
练习就是意思就是你本来不会才叫练习，练习就是不容易哈。
And because practicing means that you didn't know before, so it is not easy.
那我们的耶稣基督进到你的第二个家以后
，So when Lord Jesus has entered into your second home,
就很想要把他的爱也给了你。
He really wants to give his love to you.
那这时候他帮助了我们几件事情。
And at this point, he has helped us for a few things.
那我们写在那个投影上面。
And so we've written it on the slide.
所以你就会看到说，天父真神呢，这个耶稣基督，他知道我们的原来的家庭其实带给我们一些，抱歉跟遗憾。
But he knows that the family that we come from has also given us some regrets.
那我们已经对，我们已经知道这个就是一个事实。
And we now know that this is normal.
这个事实就是事实了。
This is reality.
对，就事实不用再讨论了。
So we don't have to talk about anymore about reality.
所以这个事实的意思就是说，我一定会有后悔、遗憾的事。
So this reality is that you definitely will have things that you regret.
我现在的下一步就是，我才明白，或是我愿意练习这个事实呢，帮助了我往天父的方向走。
And now we acknowledge that this regret will help us to walk along the heavenly path.
如果没有之前的这个事情
，If we did not have the things in the past，
没有这些遗憾跟抱歉
，If we did not have these regrets，
我们会觉得自己还蛮好的
，Then we might think that we are very good。
可是这一次，我们就会觉得自己原来。大脑里面也受伤了。
But now we have learned that in our brains we have also received harm.
逼着我们也要谦卑一点。
So therefore we must be more humble.
就是要去寻求帮助。
That is, we must go out and ask for help.
这个才是一个正常的脑。
And this is a normal brain.
就是我不好，我不够，但是我愿意去学。
That is, we are not enough, we are not good enough, but we are willing to go learn.
就原来才明白，哦，是这个原来的家庭呢，第一个家庭 把我们带来的遗憾把我们推向了耶稣基督。
But it's saying that the first family that we had in regret pushed us towards Lord Jesus.
本来我们觉得耶稣就是在旁边而已。
Before we thought that Lord Jesus was only on the side.
这一次才知道说耶稣基督原来是要进到我们的心里面去。
But now we've learned that Lord Jesus wants to come into our hearts.
圣经里面已经说了。
And the Bible already said
this. 对不对？他说什么？他说什么？他要进入我们的生命。
The Bible says that the Lord wants to enter into our life.
然后他说他也给我们新的生命，新的哦，第二个家，新的生命。
And next it also says that it's given us a new life.
你有发现不同在哪里吗？
Do you see where the difference is?
他要你的生命跟他的生命是合在一起。
He wants your life and his life to be connected together.
然后变成一个新的生命。
And now it becomes a new life.
可是现在哦，你看我们的想法不知道是不是这样。
But now you see, we might have this concept in our brains.
我们有一点点哦，有一点点把耶稣放在旁边。
We might have put Jesus a little bit to the side.
就他还是一个，叫做什么，你的神。
He is still our God.
小心这个观念哦。
Be careful of this concept.
因为你有一点点把神放成有一点像偶像。
Because then you might make God a little bit like an idol.
懂吗？因为它是文化的问题，文化。
This is a cultural issue.
对对，因为你真的有文化的东西。
Because you have something called culture in you.
你把神放这儿。
If you put God here.
你当然不是去什么拜偶像 ，OK?
Of course, you're not worshiping an idol.
可是你的文化里面有这个东西。
But your language might have this kind of, your culture might have this kind
of. 你把神摆这儿。
Concept. You have God here.
我过我的生活。
I live my life.
结果遇到问题了。
And when I have problems.
我就来跟他讲。
Then I'll talk to him.
小心这个。
So you must be careful about this.
我们有一点这个问题。
You might have a little bit of this problem.
你把神当成一个东西。
Because now you treat God as some object.
很不尊重他。
So you do not revere him.
因为他说他的生命和我的生命要连在一起。
Because he said that his life and our life must be together.
是我把他放在那。
But I put him on the side.
出门前跟他讲话。
So before I leave the house, I talk to him.
有没有？有吗？求你带我平安。
Please be guide me safely.
顺利。
Let me have a smooth journey.
健健康康。
And let me be healthy.
然后出去了。
And then you go up.
做自己想做的事。
And then you do your own thing.
然后又回来了。
And then you come back.
哎呦，谢谢你。
Thank you, Lord.
谢谢你啊，让我今天平安。
Thank you for letting me have peace.
你把神放在这。
So now you put God to the side.
他不会跟你工作的。
So he will not work with you.
因为这不是他的东西。
Because it's not his.
是你的东西。
It is your thing.
你把这一套外面的东西带进来了。
So you brought out the outside ideas into it.
要小心啊！
So you must be very careful.
一辈子是停在那边不会进步的。
Because then you might be stuck there for a whole lifetime and never improve.
他说的话是说，他的生命跟我的生命要合在一起。
What he said is that his life and our life must come together.
然后要转成一个新的生命。
And now we have to transform into a new life.
在这个新的生命里面，你有平安。
And in this new life, you will have peace.
你不用求哎。
You do not have to beg.
你要做的工作是怎么想办法跟他连在一起。
The work that you have to do is figuring out how to attach yourself to him.
现在不是啊，现在你是努力的求他。
But now, right now, you're asking him fervently.
好像他很难答应你。
It's as if he's very hard to get an answer from.
你用方法一直求他。
You find different ways to ask him.
不是错哦。
It's not wrong.
是怪怪的。
But it's strange.
就你们两个的关系怪怪的。
That is, your relationship with God is very strange.
他的生命跟你已经在一起了。
Then his life and your life is your together.
你跟我的工作是怎么认识他？
Our job is to find out how to recognize him.
怎么认识？就他是谁？怎么认识？这个新生命是什么？
Just recognize what is he and what is our lives.
而不是你是你，他是他。
It's not I am him, I am me, and he is him.
然后就一直觉得哟，你的东西很难做。
And then say that oh, your things are very hard to do.
我们有这个味道吗？有。
We have this kind of things too.
有一点这个 taste.
We have this kind of taste.
有吗？你很难做哟，做不到哦。
It's very hard for me to do your thing.
你帮我哟。
Help me.
你看，很像韩剧哈。像不像那个口音啊？
也是一个
口音。帮我哟，你很难做哟。
帮我哟。
对对对，然后他不回答，他不回答，他不回答。
你都不回答
哟。 我怎么办哦？就这样，就你的整一辈子就这样绕。
And so your entire life is in this cycle.
很快你就老了。
And very soon you'll be very old.
你就发现说怎么人生是这样。
And then you start wondering how come man life is like this.
这一节课最后的就是说，我们跟神的关系要调整好。
So what the final message of this course is that we must arrange our relationship with God properly.
所以所有世上这个家庭带给我之前的遗憾跟抱歉。
So all the regrets that our former family had, has given us,
原来是帮助我转方向，让神进到我的生命。
Is to help us change our direction to let God enter into our hearts.
这一定要调整好。
And so this is a concept that we must understand properly.
所有的方法你都会很失望，很失望。
Otherwise, any other method will cause you to lose hope.
回家小心哦。
So when you go home, you must be careful.
你跟神的说话如果没有变
，if the way that you converse with God does not change,
其实把神当成一个东西放在这拜他。
If you put God to the side and treat him as a thing to worship,
你不用笑人家什么外邦人内邦，不用笑他们。
You don't have to laugh at anyone else.
你没有变的。
You have not changed.
求平安啊。
You ask God for peace.
一个礼拜才来一次。
You come by once a week.
听完了之后出去做自己想做的。
And when you go home, you just do the things you want.
然后要平安就来求了。
And when you want peace, just come and beg for it.
像不像啊？像不像？
It does sound like you.
像不像就是把它摆在那？
That is the sound that you just put him there.
不可以哦。
So we should not do this.
我的神不是这样的神。
Because this is not our kind of God.
我的耶稣是进到我的生命帮我成长的耶稣。
Our Jesus is the one who comes into our hearts to help us grow.
Okay, 懂了哈。
So we understand this now.
我们再来看第二个。
So let's look at the next point.
他就告诉我们说他没有时间。
And he said that he does not have time.
但是他把时间给我们。
But he given us time.
你就要知道时间是一个恩赐，一个恩典。
So you must understand that time is grace.
因为他没有时间。
Because he has no time.
他不需要时间。
He does not need time.
可是他却把时间赏给我们。
But he has given us time.
那你就会知道你受伤的时候。
So you know that when you are hurt.
你需要一点时间。
You need some time.
你的这个受伤会什么结疤，然后慢慢好起来。
And then your injury will be scarred and then it will slowly heal.
他用这个概念帮我们认识自己的大脑。
And so he uses this concept to help us understand our own brains.
他希望我们经过这个受伤之后，知道什么是危险的。
He wants us to, after going through this process, to know what is dangerous.
所以他就叫我们重新把我们的生活的顺序排列一下。
So he asks us to go through our lives and rearrange our priority.
那他就觉得说，你觉得我是你生命的人吗？生命最重要的吗？
And then he asks us, do you feel that I am the most important part of your life?
你就会排列他的顺序。
And so now you are, prioritize.
可是不要忘记哦。
But do not forget.
你会忘记他。
You will forget him.
因为你还是你自己很厉害的自己的大脑。
Because you are still your own brain.
所以他会重复。
So he will repeat.
不用伤心。
Do not worry.
你已经在进步了。
You already improving.
不要一掉下来就觉得我又失败了。
Do not think that if you fall down that you have already lost.
因为耶稣在用爱撑住你。
Because God is using love to support you.
所以他会重复，不要怕。
So he will repeat it. Do not be afraid.
有一个弟兄，他说他生病好了。
There was a brother that said that after he was sick, he was healed.
他在生病的时候。
And he said during the time he was ill.
他跟主耶稣说，如果我病好，我要这样的服侍你来教会。
He says that if I get better, then I want to serve you like this and this and this in the church.
原来你这么重要，如果没有你，我根本站不起来。
That if it wasn't for you and that I will not even be able to stand.
这就是神让我们遇到困难的时候，他想要我们排列的顺序。
This is God when He gives us troubles. He wants us to learn to rearrange our priorities.
就弟兄后来好了之后，不到一个月哦。
But after just a month of getting better,
又开始很忙碌了。
He started getting busy again.
为什么？因为回到了生活里面。
Why? Because he's re-entered into life.
他就告诉我说，不可能的咯，很难的咯。
And he started telling me, oh, it's not possible. It's very hard.
生活就是这样的咯。
Like this.
你就发现他的顺序就又变了。
So now you see that his priorities is changing again.
没有关系。
It's okay.
因为神是这样子帮助我们长大。
Because God is using this to help us grow up.
好像你养小孩。
For example, when you raise a child,
他会重复的犯错。
He will keep doing the things wrong.
你怎么办？
What do you do?
接受他。
You accept him.
又告诉他。
You tell him again.
他就又好一点。
And then he's getting a little bit better.
明天他又忘记了。
And tomorrow he'll forget again.
对，你会发现跟我们很像。
So you see that it's very just the same. It's the same for us.
第三。
Three.
我们真的要在他的话语上还有在圣灵上得到很多的帮助。
We must receive a lot of help from his truth and the spirit.
那个帮助现在我们有一个新的概念。
And his help we have this new concept.
他原来是要帮助我们建立安全。
He wants us to have this security.
所以他用很多的界限画出来了。
So he has a lot of boundaries drawn for us.
所以你其实会安全。
So really you will be secure.
在这安全里面你慢慢会 enjoy.
And the security you will slowly enjoy.
这个叫做滋润，我们就是得到水啦，得到快乐，就是在这个里面。
So this is the time we will receive this joy and this water.
所以你只要一觉得好像要读神的话，或是祷告的时候，你觉得不舒服，不喜欢。
So you find that when you're about to offend God or when you're praying, you feel that you do not like it.
那个时候就是你的 checklist 帮助你说，弟兄姐妹，你可能现在有一点点又跑出去喽，那个范围跑出去喽。
This is a checklist for you to indicate to you that you might be outside of the boundaries.
因为新的人，新的生命会喜欢神的话语。
Because with a new life and new boundaries, you will enjoy God's word.
因为是跟他一样的。
Because it is the same as He is.
他不会说我很喜欢神爱我，但是他的话很难，我不喜欢。他不会。
You won't say that. Oh, I like how God loves me, but I find that His words are very difficult.
好啦，弟兄姐妹，弟兄姐妹，去找一下自己的阳光、空气跟水。
So next, brothers and sisters, please find your own sun, water, and air.
一定要去想这个问题。
You must think about this problem.
因为你觉得这个大自然给的这个东西太奇妙，对不对？
Because you see that this creation is so miraculous.
这三个基本的东西是帮一个人成长，就帮一个生命成长的。
And these three basic things are helping a person to grow.
那你就用你聪明的头脑分析一下。
So now you use your own smart brain to think about it.
阳光是什么？
What is the sun?
会让一个人有什么感觉？
What would it make you feel like?
温暖啊。
It'll make you feel warm.
热啊。
It'll make you feel hot.
去找一个在每一天生活里面有什么东西会让你觉得温暖跟热的。
So find in your life, what is it that will make you feel warm and hot?
常常去接触。
And always come to receive it.
你怎么样会觉得是温暖的感觉呢？
Why do you feel that you are being warm?
可能你帮助人的时候。
Perhaps it's the time when you're helping others.
结果那个人就跟你说了一声很感激的话。
And then that person shows you some appreciation.
你就觉得人生充满了温暖。
And then you'll feel that your life is full of warmth.
我不知道，我帮你讲的。
I don't know, these are just examples.
所以我才不能乱讲，因为你自己有你的阳光。
So I cannot just say anything because you have your own sunlight.
那空气是什么呢？
So what is air?
如果你吸了一口新鲜的空气。
If you breathe this fresh air.
那是什么感觉？
What is the feeling?
那用这个感觉再去找你二十四小时里面什么时候还有这样的感觉。
So look through and see what you have when in your 24 hours have you also felt this.
是听一首诗歌吗？
Is it when you listen to a hymn?
还是听一个见证吗？
Or when you hear a testimony? I do not know.
你要自己去找。
So you must find it.
我没办法帮你了。
I can't help you.
那这个水是什么呢？
What is this water?
渴的时候你喝下去水那一瞬间的感觉是什么呢？
What is the feeling when you're so thirsty and you down a glass of water?
你就去找在二十四小时有什么感觉会让你这样
So you look through your 24 hours and see what makes you feel like you have the sound.
那你就会你自己就有你自己每个人都不同了你自己的阳光空气跟水。
So find your own sunlight, air and water.
因为这个是天父给你的。
Because this is what the Lord has given you.
这三个东西就会帮助你修正大脑。
And these three things will help you repair your brain.
那另外一个修正大脑的就是他希望我们常常的赞美他。
And the fourth one is that he always wants us to express our thanks.
因为从他的那个话语我认识了。
Because through his words I recognize.
不是只有求他。
It's not only asking him.
他喜欢我们赞美。
He enjoys us praising him.
他喜欢我们常常感谢。
He enjoys us always giving thanks.
可是日子真的很苦。
But the days are truly bitter.
那就是说你凡事都要感谢。
And so we have said that we always have to give thanks.
好像练习说话一样。
It's like giving learning how to speak.
就是你明明觉得你讲不出来。
You feel that you cannot say it out.
你就要练习讲。
So then you need to practice saying it.
主，我真的很苦。
Lord, I am very bitter.
我很伤心。
I'm very worried.
我很失望。
I've lost hope.
但是我还是要感谢你。
But I still want to give thanks to you.
这样子去跟神讲话。
So use this to speak to God.
这个就是合乎他让我认识他想要的东西。
And this is to recognize the thing that he would want.
最后一个你要记得哦，他很在乎你的，在乎你。
And the last one is that he cares about your marriage.
嗯，就是你。
Don't care for you.
对，他就是你，就是他很喜欢问你你好吗。
And he really likes to ask how are you.
那你从今天之后就知道，他只要问你你好吗的时候，你就不用再去讲别的东西了。
对 ，Now you know that when he asks how you are, that you don't have to talk about anything else.
因为他问的是你这个人。
Because he's asking about you, the person.
我不好。
You can say I'm not good.
还是我好。
Or I am good.
还是我好像快不行了。
Or I cannot stand it any longer.
但我又要感谢你。
But I still need to give thanks to you.
教教我吧。
Teach me.
这个就是跟他连在一起。
And this is what it means to attach to him.
就不用说你看他，你看他，就不用再讲。
So you don't have to say, you have to look at this other person and this other person. Don't say
things. 所以我们要练习每一次我们叫做什么？下一次我们失落或是下一次失望的时候。
So the next time you have lost hope.
我们其实要用这样子的一个新的方向去想。我跟神的关系。
Then we have this new method to think about our relationship with God.
这个叫做重新第二个家里面用爱建造起来的。
And this is what it means that using the second family to use love to build up.
弟兄姐妹，我们只能分享这样子。弟兄姐妹，我们剩下的就是回家练肌肉。
And now we all can do is to go home and practice.
保养皮肤。
And to protect our own skin.
对不对，姐妹？你们知道保养皮肤是每天的。
And sisters, you know that to protect your skin is something you have to do every day.
对，肌肉是每天的。
So just practice every day.
你们懂这个道理的时候，你就知道，何况你这个都是要保养，那么你的。跟耶稣的关系不保养吗？
If you have this understood concept that you protect your skin every day, then how can you not protect your relationship with God every day?
对，你不保养，然后你只要他给你平安。
If you don't protect it and you only ask him to give you peace,
那个意思就是把它放在这。
Then that means you're only putting him to the side.
不好，这个是错的观
念。This is the wrong concept.
练习一下哦。耶稣是在你的里面，而不是放在这。
Jesus is within you and not putting him to the side.
那这样子我们就开始调整跟耶稣的关系。
And then we'll come to understand our relationship with Jesus.
你知道吗？我们每一天开始就有一点点的喜乐进来了。
And then you know that every day we'll have a little bit of joy that comes into us.
有一个姐妹真的很伟大。
There was a sister that was really great.
我觉得她的生活真的非常的苦。
I felt that her life was very bitter.
因为她的重新第二个家的家人是会打她的。
Because her people in the second family would beat her.
但是她明白了这样的一个爱的道理之后。
But after she comes to understand the idea of love.
没有再告诉我说我改了，就是一直被她打。
She no longer says that I have changed and just keep being beaten by
her. 你改的意思就是我对他好，那不是打死我了吗？
If what you mean by changing is I have treated them well, doesn't mean that they'll just beat.
因为以前他们对打。
Because in the past they would fight each other.
对，因为他觉得不能让他。
Because she felt that she couldn't let them.
我让了他还得了啊？
And how can I let them just beat me?
所以他打他就咬。
So one person beats her, she'll bite.
真的，所以他就觉得他一直没有输。
So she felt that she had never lost.
可是她很苦。
But she was very bitter.
怎么会跟一个打人的人在一起？
How can I live with someone who was beats me?
那明白了，这样了，这样爱的道理。
So she understands the concept of love.
很勇敢哦。
She was very brave.
她不再来告诉我说，如果我让她，她打死我怎么办？
She no longer said that if I let her them and they beat me, what would happen?
她说，我只知道从我开始做起。
She only knows that it starts from myself.
我的神是站在我这里的。
That my God stands with me.
因为我建立这个家庭是因为耶稣进来。
Because I established this family because Jesus has come.
才这样子想哎。
And so she started thinking like this.
她老公变了。
And so then her husband changed.
没有人知道为什么变。
No one knows why he changed.
就是耶稣原来去找她去了。
And but the Lord Jesus also went home.
那天晚上这个老公做了一个梦。
So that night, her husband had a dream.
你敢再欺负我的女儿，你试试看。
It's the dream was you dare You didn't harm my daughter again. You just watched me.
耶稣讲话也是蛮不客气的。
And so sometimes Jesus, when he talked, he'd be very tough.
用他的口气跟他讲话。
So he used his own, the husband's own voice to speak to him.
你再试试看啊。
You want to try this again?
你再打我女儿试试看。
You want to beat my child again?
他就这样子啊，那天之后啊，像猫一样。还煮饭呢。
You make dinner.
这姐妹吓死了。
And so the sister was very shocked.
怎么会变这样呢？
And so she thought, how did he change from this?
难道这是最后的晚餐吗？你不敢吃啊。
She really didn't want to eat it.
同归于尽怎么办？一起吃对吧？
Because she didn't want to die.
那你先吃。
So she didn't eat first.
她先生就吃得很开心啊。
And so her husband ate very happily. 她
不吃哎。
But she didn't eat.
耶稣帮他改了，他不太相信。
She didn't quite believe it.
第二天
，the second day，
第三天
，the third day，
第四天
，the fourth day，
因为他真的没死啊。
And really, she did not die.
你怎么变了
？And so how did you change？
我完全不认识你。
I do not recognize you.
不敢讲。
He didn't dare say.
不好意思讲。
It was too ashamed to say it.
因为你的耶稣来找我了。
Because Jesus came to find me.
你是怎么祷告的
？And so, yeah, how did you pray?
No, 我是你的祷告。我没有祷告，我就我的生活就跟你在一起，我祷告什么？就你不要打我就好了。
That's like he said, "Oh, I can't pray. I'm with you. So just."
我最多的祷告就是你不要打我。
So my prayers is you don't beat me.
他就说，哦，就这样祷告。那你神为什么要来找我啊
？And so he said, "Oh, welcome you to God. Look for me."
这个先生来这样信耶稣。
And so this is how her husband came to believe in Jesus.
你相信吗？
Do you believe it?
你相信只因为你想改变，我的耶稣站在你这边吗？
Do you believe that if you're willing to change, then God, Lord Jesus will be with you?
最难就是我不太相信。
So the toughest part is that we do not quite believe.
耶稣就让你继续走。
So Lord Jesus will let you continue to go on.
他第二个家他进来了。
So in the second home, he came in.
姐妹弟兄，事实已经是事实。
The truth is.The fact is that
不用觉得自己嫁错人。
You don't have to worry about anymore.
也不用再想什么，事实就是事实。
You don't have to worry about anything else. Just reality is reality.
我的耶稣只问你现在。
But Jesus is only asking about today.
这个才是希望。
This is true hope.
没有一个医生敢这样问你。
No other doctor will dare say this to you.
医生，我们就是问你以前。
The doctors will ask for the past.
你讲越多，我钱拿的越多。
The more you talk about, the more money I get.
然后你讲完之后，我就说没救了。
And if you say it all, I'll just say there's no hope.
我的耶稣跟我完全不一样。
But my Jesus is completely different.
我的耶稣只问现在。
My Jesus only asks.
孩子，你信吗
？Right now, do you believe?
你转头吗
？Have you turned around?
我跟你在一起。
I will be with you.
弟兄姐妹
，brothers and sisters.
这是我的爱。
This is our love.
重建。
This is how we establish our family.
耶稣祝福大家。
Well, Jesus bless all.
我要把时间交给传道。
So now I'm going to pass my time to the preacher.
谢谢。谢
谢。阿利利亚，奉耶稣圣名讲话。
阿利利亚，奉耶稣圣名讲话。
感谢神带领这一次的讲习会，很顺利的完成。
Thank God that this.Training has successfully completed.
虽然时间很短
even though the time is very short,
但是大家从欢笑的声音有笑有泪也是很开心，但是也是做很深的反省。
But from everyone's laughter and tears, it seems that everyone had a good time, but not everyone has had a chance to do some reflection.
小弟跟大家分享两节经节，我们在最后结束的祷告。
So I would like to share with you some Bible verses before I conclude.
首先请打开耶利米书第十章。
Let's turn to Jeremiah chapter 10.
第十十九节。
Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 19.
耶利米书第十章十九到二十节。
Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 19 to 20.
十章十九节。
Jeremiah 19. 10 verse 19.
民说祸灾，我受损伤，我的伤痕极其重大，我却说这真是我的痛苦，必须忍受。第二十节
verse 20.
我的帐篷毁坏，我的绳索折断，我的儿女离我出去没有了，没有人再知道我的帐篷，挂起我的幔子。这是一幅非常悲哀的图画。
This is a very sorrowful image.
是以色列百姓他们面对被掳了，面对家破人亡的一个图案。
对 ，this is when the Israelites face the destruction of their land.
那从整个国家被灭亡。
And this entire nation has been destroyed.
讲到很多的家庭也会被影响。
And it is talked about how so many families were influenced.
那家庭被影响最明显的就是儿女都出去了，人没有了。
And the biggest impact of families is that the sons and daughters have all left.
不是真的是没有了，而是可能不跟你联络了。
And perhaps it's not that they are gone, but they no longer talk to you.
这是从政治，从国家可以讲到家庭，也可以讲到今天属灵的这种情况。
And so this can talk about the nation, about the family, or can be brought to today's spiritual situation.
儿女离开我出去只是一个最后的结果。
That the sons and daughters leaving us is just the final result.
原因就是因为这个帐篷的绳索断。
But the reason is because the relationship with God is gone.
那这个绳子。
So the sorry string. There's a cord that's broken.
这时候我们去 camping 啊，你一定是挂那个帐幕之前要先把绳子拉好。
Just like when we are camping, before we start putting up the tent, we must tie this cord strongly.
那如果那个绳子断了，那个帐篷倒下来了，在里面的人当然就是要走了。
But if this cord breaks, then of course the tent collapses on everyone.
那个绳索代表什么呢？
So what does this cord represent?
那代表一个家庭里面的爱。
It represents the love of the family.
一个家庭有房子、有车子、有饭吃，这个只是物质上的东西。
The family having money, a house to live in, or a car to drive, or food to eat, these are all just the superficial things.
但是呢，最关键的是呢，看不见的绳子。
But the most important part is the cord that they cannot see.
第一就是夫妻之间的爱。
First is the love between husband and wife.
夫妻之间如果没有爱，或者是爱很少。
If the husband and wife has no love or has very little love.
或是不交流，没有沟通。
Or perhaps if you don't communicate.
当然这个绳子就等于断了。
Then that means that the cord is broken.
那孩子呢就会出去。
And so then the children will leave.
再来我们跟孩子之间的爱关心。
And second of all is our relationship with the children.
我们也要反省是不是也断了。
We have to reflect on ourselves. Has it been broken?
是不是我们只会要求。
Is it that we only know how to request?
读书啊。
Go on to study.
成绩啊。
The marks.
要他学五样十样东西啊。
Or to learn 5 or 10 things.
然后呢一直的要求。
And so we always demand on them.
但是孩子感觉不到我们对他的关心。
But the children cannot feel our relationship with them.
说要关心啊，我关心在学业啊。
So if there is a relationship, then it's only a relationship in school.
你关心他学业不等于关心他。
And then, so the fact that you care for the school doesn't mean that you care for him.
所以从今天这几天我们所学的课程。
So from these courses that we took the last few days.
听到我们一定要在家里面重建爱。
That we know that we must reestablish our family.
那个绳子哪里断了？
So where has the cord been broken?
当然你很痛苦。
Of course it is very painful.
你说你自己受伤吗？其实孩子也受伤。
You think that it's been painful for you, but it's also painful for the children.
你这里说第十九节说我受的伤极其重大。
And here it says that my wound is grievous.
受伤是双方面都有受伤。
And so this kind of wound is kind of the emotional wound.
你用手去打人，你的手也会痛。
If you hit somebody, your hand will also hurt.
你骂人的时候，自己也会生气，很痛苦。
And when you yell at someone, then you will also be hurt as well.
痛苦的一开始当然就是忍受。
And so the start of the hurt is
You have to endure. 在我们还没有来上课之前，我们大概就只会忍受，就忍了，就忍了，就忍受，忍到不能再忍再说了。
And so in this, at the beginning of this course, we might only know how to endure it, and so we start enduring it, but then eventually we break.
但是这两天我们学习的课程
，But in these 2 days courses,
我们有看到希望。
We've seen hope.
原来不单只是忍受。
It's really, it's not just about enduring.
我们要把那个绳子从哪里断了，要把它捡起来，要把它接回去。
That wherever the cord has been broken, we must find it and retie together.
这个就是我们在祷告当中要想。
And so this is something that we must think about when we're praying.
不单只是你跟你配偶的绳子。
Not only the cord between you and your spouse.
你跟儿女的绳子。
But also the cord with your children.
我们真正要接的是我们跟神之间的绳子。
And we, the cord we must fix is the cord between us and God.
如果你没有把这个绳子跟神接起来，
if we do not fix this cord with God,
你自己的心没有感觉到神的爱，
if our hearts cannot feel the love of God,
最重要的绳子没有绑回来，
if we do not tie the most important cord back together,
你其他再怎么努力也是白白的浪费掉，
then everything else that we do will just waste time.
所以我们再来看何西阿书。
So next let's turn to Hosea.
第六章。
Hosea chapter 6.
何西阿书第六章
Hosea chapter 6
第一到第三节
Verse 1 to 3
我们一起大声读、
So that's how we read it.
用这三节真经节总结我们这两天所学习的
And use this to conclude the courses that we learned from the last few days.
回去要怎么样改变你是在这几节当中
And how we go back home and change ourselves in these verses.
一二三
1, 2, 3
来吧我们归向耶和华他撕裂我们也必医治我们他打伤我们也必查我过两天他必使我们苏醒第三天他必使我们兴起我们就在他面前得以存活我们务要认识耶和华竭力追求认识他他出现却如晨光他必临到我们像甘雨像滋润田地的春雨阿们
好
我们都以这几节圣经作为这次讲习会的总结
And so we will use these verses as our conclusion our central theme for this course
虽然我们好像被撕裂了
Even though we feel like we've been torn
在家里好像被撕裂了
And perhaps our household has been destroyed
但是主要来医治
But the Lord is here to heal.
只有主耶稣能够医治。
And only Lord Jesus can heal.
心理医生也没有办法医治。
The psychiatrist cannot heal.
你每年去旅游十次也没有办法医治。
And even if you go to on vacation 10 times a year, you cannot heal it.
一定要回到主耶稣那里才有办法得医。
Only when you come to Jesus can it be healed.
就好像我们有病要去找医生。
Just like when we are ill, we look for a doctor.
我们这一次学到的是我们每个人头脑都受伤
And this time we learned that our brains have been all brains have been damaged
你要承认我是一个受伤的人
And so we must acknowledge that we are a broken person
你要求主耶稣医治我
So we must ask God to heal us
那主耶稣打伤我们主耶稣让我们被打伤他也会把我们包起来
And so when Lord Jesus lets us be injured he will also heal us
这个可以用什么来包扎
And what can he use to heal us
就是用神的爱
As he will use God's love
那个 OK 棒那个绷带
And he will use it to bind our wounds.
让我们受伤的心灵能够得到医治。
And so the heart that we have that been injured will heal.
好，第二节说第二天呢，你就醒过来了。
And then the verse 2 says that after 2 days he will revive us.
我们这两天只是被醒过来，被敲醒过来。
So the last 2 days we have been awakened.
我们Daniel老师花了那么多时间。那么慢的在讲，让大家笑得那么开心，其实就要我们醒过来。他用笑的当中，要我们被骂醒过来。
And so the teacher has gone through all the concepts very slowly, and has allowed us to laugh so that he can revive us again.
直接骂你啊，你根本不会醒过来。你说你骂什么，讲什么，老师讲来讲去都是那一些要悔改。
And if he only scolded us, then we might think, oh, why is he scolding us again? Oh, he's always we're just.Being scolded,
谁要改？我的家。
Who would want to change?
但这两天我们学校原来说我们都需要改。
But in the last couple of days, we learned that we all have to change.
所以你醒过来了吗？这两天。
So have you been revived these last 2 days?
好，那第三天呢？醒过来之后呢，就必兴起。
And so here on the third day, he will raise us up.
你如果还没有醒过来，就不会兴起。
If you have not been revived, then you will not raise up.
一定要醒过来。
So first, we must be revived.
醒过来要做什么？
And when we're revived, what we have to do?
如果你听完那个课了啊，笑一笑啊，很好听啊，开车回去了，又回到自己的样子，那就没有用。
So if we only listen to for the last couple of days and laugh a little bit and then return home but don't do anything with it, then it's of no use.
这是第三节。
So this is what the verse is.
认识，追求认识神。
So the third verse is we need to learn to know God.
你说我要解决我的问题啊？
You might say that, and I want to solve all my problems.
怎么样解决我的问题、啊、
How do I solve all my problems?
问题不在你的问题。
The problem is not in your problems.
问题是你在你跟神的关系。
The problem is your relationship with God.
你越认识神，你的问题就会慢慢解决。
If you know the Lord, then your problems will slowly be solved.
因为越认识神，你就越认识自己。
Because the more you recognize God, the more you recognize yourself.
你认识了自己了，就知道怎么样来更正自己。
And when you recognize yourself, then you know how you should change yourself.
好了，你一回转。
So if you change,
神就会出现好像晨光。
Then the Lord will come out to you like
Daniel 老师给我们看到希望。
And so just in the last session, Brother Daniel has given us hope.
这个希望，这个光会越来越大。如果你回去归向神
，and this hope will grow, become bigger and bigger.
啊，神会给我们甘雨。
And so the Lord will give us showers.
滋润我。
And He will heal.
啊，这个就是我们以这一节尊敬节来总结我们这两天学习它。
And so that's how we will use these verses to summarize the last few days.
当然了，时间很短。
And of course, the time has been short.
大家意犹未尽，希望可以多学一点。
And so if everyone has an opportunity, I hope everyone can learn more.
啊，我们也希望 Daniel 老师可以以后多抽时间。
And I hope that Brother Daniel can one day have some more time.
讲完就问，为什么只排一个地方，没有排另外一个地方
？And we always ask, how come you only sending him to one place, not other?
我说我会转达。我会转达。
Forward the request.
Oh, forward the
request.
只要Daniel老师的时间抽了出来，我们都非常愿意。
So as long as he has the opportunity, we are very willing.
好，那我们为过去一个星期的这个课程来感谢神。
So we thank the Lord for the last few days of classes.
也谢谢Daniel老师给我们抽出宝贵的时间来跟我们做分享。
And we thank Brother Daniel for taking some time to give us the sharing.
在最后祷告之前，我们来再唱这次的主题曲。
And so before we conclude, let's sing our hymn one more time.
343首
343.
希望我们的爱在家庭里面被重建。
So we hope that the love in our homes can be reestablished.
最后我们就要做最后的结束祷告。
And then afterwards, we will do our concluding prayer.